Okay, guys, got the camera rolling here. Anyways, today I'm working on the ZMR250 RoboCat. And I don't know why they call it a 250 when it's actually 275 millimeters from blade tip to blade tip. But anyways, I bought the frame kit. So it's a very, very simple frame kit. Goes together really, really well, okay? And there's a nice big gap between these two pieces of carbon fiber. That's where the battery goes in. And then this piece goes on the top, like this, and attaches to the front. Okay, and then it has these nice fancy-looking side panels that go on that are colored. And this front nose. So this goes on and your FPV camera looks out through the front. So there's places to put all your stuff on the top here. I'm going to end up putting my transmitter on top like this. Yeah, so I've been throwing this together. I actually built it already, but in order to, get all the hardware all set up and everything, I had to take it apart again. So I just had to take these two layers apart. I have all the rest of the stuff screwed in here, but now I ordered from AliExpress. These are 2212 9. I forget. Anyways, they're really high speed motors. They're actually made for the DJI. So I also got some 30 amp Simunk speed controllers with the motors, which I haven't hooked up yet, but I got the motors in place. I got the ESCs hooked up. I've got my Terret 8 LED 7 color spot, whatever you call it. It's not a spotlight, but a tail light. I got it installed, and I'm using these. I ordered these little power hubs. Very nice. They're Matac. It's a 5 volt, 12 volt mini power hub. So everything hooks into it. Very, very nice instructions. All the specifications there. And it has all the connections here for your camera, your video transmitter, all your ESCs, your battery, and so on and so forth. So I've got all that stuff. You can also select whether your camera is 12 volts or your transmitter is 12 volt or 5 volt, or whether you want it running off the VCC, which is just basically the battery power. So anyways, I've got my FPV camera, right? The camera is right here. So I've got to mount it into the front of the copter, looking out through the opening. And there's a neat little piece here for putting your camera in. There's four of them. There's four of them on this piece here that are for various different things. But there's the camera. So I've got it already wired in. All I have to do is just plug the camera in. So, but I'm not going to do that yet. I'm going to do it later. I got my wiring all in for the transmitter. So basically I just need to plug this into the transmitter and it'll be running off 12 volts. It's a 600 watt 48 channel. So it'll work with my Esheen goggles. And I do have some better antennas than these. I have some nice circular polarization antennas that I'm going to put on it. So anyways, I got this all wired up. I got the ESCs all connected up. It turns out that these ESCs actually have a 5 volt out BEC built into them, which I'm not going to use, or I am going to use. So what I've done is I've removed the center pin on three of these speed controller wires, and motor one is the one that's going to provide the 5 volts for the receiver and the flight controller. So I need to put those in here next, but they'll be on the next layer, the top layer here. I got my little, I don't know where it is right now, but my little antenna should be right here. Here it is. Yeah. I got my receiver antenna holder. So the nice thing about these is they have a little slot in the back here. And basically, it will just slide right on to the back of your carbon fiber frames. And then that keeps your receiver antenna at a 45 or a 90 degree angle. So, now, what else was I going to show you here? So I got to put this layer on next, which I'm all ready to do. I'll show you the LED here. Hopefully I don't try anything here, but I got the LED. BEC power hub has 2 LEDs here to show you whether your 5 volts and your 12 volts is turned on. And this is going to be the LED on the bottom here, so I can see it from the ground. This, you can change the colors to whatever you want. There's 7 different colors. The white color uses the most power, so I chose not to use that one. So, and I'm powering this with a 11.1 volt, 1500 milliamp battery. Like I said, there's plenty of space to put the battery in the middle layer, but that's not the battery I'm going to use. I have some 2200s coming. It should be here next week. So I'm using a FlySky remote, so I have the FlySky 6-channel receiver, which is all I'm going to need for this simple racer copter. So I got that all set up, and I just got to basically plug the wires in, and it's ready to go. And it's gonna end up being on this layer right here, which is going to be below this. So it's going to be, the receiver is going to sit right in here, and my antenna is going to stick out the top, my 90 degree receiver antenna. So, and I'm going to power this with my flight controller. I'm going to use on this is the CC3D flight controller. Very simple. I think, what is this, Open Pilot? I think that's what they call it. So I got all these wires and stuff to hook up, which is fairly simple. And then my servo motors, or not my servos, my speed controllers will hook up to the 6 outputs here that come out of the flight controller. So I'm pretty well done. It's really early in the morning here right now. I'm pretty well done what I'm going to do today on this. So the next thing I'm going to be working on tomorrow is getting the flight controller flashed if need be. I don't know whether this one needs to be flashed or not. And get the get the rest of the cover on. The nice thing about this frame is it has all these nice, they fit really well too actually, all these nice little carbon fiber pieces. So these are the sides that kind of enclose this this lower area, which is nice because it protects it from, not flying objects, but things that, might end up hitting it. I also hooked up another output here, just an auxiliary output, which I can use for something, but it's connected basically to the battery. So, anyways, I'm just going to unplug the FPV power. I got a bunch of these connectors that mate, so I used them to connect the power for the FPV using the original wiring that came with it. So I didn't have to cut and hack anything, or So what I'm going to do now is just put this second layer on here, and then I'll be able to show you how much space there is in the middle for I need to put this where I'm going to use it. So my auxiliary power is going to go down through the bottom like that, and then I'm going to tack it in somewhere. I also put a little small connector on here for the LED. You can turn the switches off to turn the LEDs off, but I put a connector there so I can unplug them if need be very easily. So anyway, so the nice thing about this setup is that they actually have holes in it for the speed controller wiring to go through. So they go through really simple, perfect size. So I'm just going to feed those wires through there right now. And that just keeps them out of the way of the battery, basically. The battery's not gonna be close to them, or not gonna touch them. So I just put the four of those up through that layer. And I'm gonna bring the FPV. It's gonna be close to the back, so I'm gonna bring it through this sole, I keep calling them servo, through the ESC connector hole for the ESC. So I just gotta slap this puppy into place here and put a couple screws in it. Just wanna make sure I'm not gonna be pinching those little wires for the LED. They're very fine little wires. So these are the screws that are needed to put it together. So if you come with these red standoffs that just screw on to the long screws that come out of the bottom. I'll show you here in a second, but if you'll notice the actual arms are super thick. They gotta be probably, I would think, 3 millimeters thick. So this is a nice little racer, FPV racer, and I believe that if I crash this thing, it's not gonna break the arms, because these arms are really thick. So just tighten these down for now. I'm not going to put all the rest of the screws in, because I may end up having to take that compartment apart tomorrow. But I have all the screws here. And then this piece goes on top like that. So you got all this space in between here to put your battery, which is quite nice. This battery fits in it just perfect. But the 2500 should fit in there just as well. So the other thing I need to do is put a rubber mat under where the battery's going to go, because if you do that, then it tends to make it so the battery doesn't slide out so easily. So I will cut a custom-sized piece of this to fit in there, so the battery's got something to lay down on. And I'm also going to put a little spacer here so that the battery can't slide forward. So I have some of those here. They're little nylon spacers, and I got nylon screws for them. So basically, this will be the, and if it does get hit really badly, or, hits the ground really hard, it will just shear off these pieces of nylon screws, or these nylon screws will get sheared off. Let me find my needle nose pliers here. So it's 3 o'clock in the morning. I always end up doing this late in the morning, late at night. I got off work early today because I went in early today, so I was able to come home and work on this for quite a few hours. I wouldn't say quite a few hours, but I think I've been working on this since about 1 o'clock or so. So I got about 2 hours into this so far, all the soldering and whatever else. So that will just break off of there if it, you know, really, really needs to break off. But simple setup. And like I said, the arms are super heavy duty carbon fiber, so I don't think they'll ever break. Just need to get these plates in the right place here. Sometimes they're a little tricky to get them in the slots, but you know when they're in the slots because they click in. But I don't know if you can see this, but see how thick those arms are? Very, very thick carbon fiber, so it should be good. I don't think it's going to break. So, like I said, next thing I'll have to do is install the receiver and get my transmitter installed on the top and my flight controller and my receiver. And then I'm ready to go. So, like I say, this is a very, very nice build. There's a Terret version of this, which I didn't know or I would have ordered because I'm very fond of the Terret products. Oh shit, I did squeeze that wire. Damn. I was worried about that. I hope I didn't wreck it. She got squished. Shit, shit, shit. I was trying to be really careful. Oh my god. I think I broke right through the wire. I'm totally going to take it apart and replace that. Damn. Don't you just hate it when things like that happen? You try your best. Well, it looks like it didn't sever the wire, but anyways, I have problems with the light. I'm going to have to replace it. Maybe what I'll do is just check to make sure here first. So, and I added some of those little nylon spacers on the bottom here just to give it, that's my landing gear. It came with these little rubber pads, but little foam pads, but I don't like them. So let me just plug this back in and see if my LED lights up. Yep. So we're good to go. So, if you guys want to watch me, I'll throw these other screws in here. I think I got it pretty well taken care of underneath there. So I double checked everything. So it should be good to go. So there's three screws that hold on each arm, and the arms actually have very well-made motor mounts. So they'll take, you know, the ones that are perfectly evenly spaced, and it'll also take the ones that have a, what I call a cockeyed spacing, where the motors are two of the holes are farther apart than the other two. It's kind of, I don't know why they would do something like that. On my new, my Terret FY680, I bought some 5010s for that. And they are a 4-point, perfectly square. The 4006 or 4008s that I bought, which are on it right now, they are only a 3-screw mount. So there's many different types of motor mounts when you're deciding to buy a copter. Make sure you get the motor mount that will fit your copter. Some of them, some of them just don't, like, I mean, you'd have to drill out the holes. My F550 will only take certain motors because of the way the things are spaced, the holes. So, here we go. I've got my top layer on here. I'm not sure exactly how I'm going to bring the wires up. Are they going to fit through that? No. So, for some reason, they make the bottom holes the right size, but not these ones. So, I'm probably going to end up hiding those wires behind the canopy. So, and like I said, this thing is very well made. Everything fits together absolutely perfectly. I haven't had to, you know, ream out any holes or anything like that. The LED on the bottom, I had to drill the holes to mount the LED. Four holes. I probably didn't need four holes, but I drilled the four holes. And the power hub, conveniently enough, actually fit into the holes that were on the bottom. So the spacing for the power hub, the four holes here were already drilled right in the bottom here. So it's very convenient that I didn't have to do that. So, like I said, not much else to do here. Bring these up like this. I might end up, just see if I got enough room there still. Should have. Oh, I put that layer on without putting my rubber piece in there. I end up taking it off again anyways. But I'm just trying to figure out where I'm going to bring these side wires up. Right where the battery's going to. So, right where the battery's going to go. Anyways, I don't think it's going to be a big deal. If I have to, I'll bring it around like this and then bring it up the top. And that keeps it out of the way of the battery. So, like so. So when I get this all put together and figured out and everything the way I want it, all I have to do is put the canopy on. It hinges to the front if you want to open the unit up and do any work on it. So once you have all this stuff in place, just bundle these up in the middle here. This goes on like that and bolts down. And then you put on your front nose piece and your side pieces like this, and bingo, you got a RoboCat. Then it'll look pretty good with the FPV transmitter sticking out the top like that. So anyways, I won't bore you guys anymore. There you have it. The ZMR 250. I call it a racer, but it's actually a RoboCat. So, anyways, and this unit doesn't have a GPS. I don't think there's a GPS hookup for the on the CC3D. I'm not sure, so I'll have to check into that because I may want to have this thing fly in GPS mode. So. Need to check on that. But there's that extra wire. I'm just going to tuck that in like that. Put a wire tie around it. But yeah, very, very nice. Just to play with the LED here for a minute or two, show you guys all the different colors or whatever. Some of the colors, maybe not all of them. But the white is super, super bright. So I need to get my battery straps, and it does have a place to put the battery straps through here. You can put them through the center layer, the side piece holes here if you want, instead of going through the bottom. You can put them through that. Oops, that. But anyways, I'm just going to play with the LEDs here for a second here. Give you an idea of... What is that? Oh, that's the thing I just tried to tuck in. The extra power wire. I don't know what for, but anyways. Now I need something to turn the switches here. I'm going to do it with the pen. Those things are super bright, but there's green. Another version of green. Off. There's blue. Purple. And of course, white. Super, super bright. I don't know if you can see that, but I mean, it's very, very bright. Lighting me up pretty good. So, I'm just going to put it back to red. How did I get the red on? In the middle? There we are. So yeah, pretty neat. These are Tarot. I bought a couple of them to put on my big Tarot copter. So, anyways, that's going to be it for now. Tomorrow, I will get the camera installed. I'll get the FPV transmitter installed. Get the rubber installed, which I'm going to have to take all this stuff off and put the rubber down anyway. So, and maybe take it out for its first flight. But I really, really, really want to fly this little baby. This should be pretty fast. These motors will lift the 550. So to have this big of a motor on this tiny little RoboCat, it's just gonna fly like crazy. So, anyways, that's it for tonight. Okay, guys. Tomorrow I will add to this video and show it with the FPV and all the rest of the stuff installed. So, thanks for watching, guys. Have a good night. Please share, like, and comment on this video if you'd like. If you need me to answer any questions whatsoever, because I am custom building copters now, if you have any questions whatsoever, please don't hesitate to ask. Okay, and all the items used to build this copter were all bought from the various sellers on AliExpress. If you don't know what AliExpress is, well, you're missing something. Okay, so thanks for watching again, guys. Talk to you later. Okay, it's the next day now, and I've got all the... This is the update on the, I think it's a ZMR 250, but I got all the banana plug ends put on the motor controllers. I got the wires all connected up for that. I got my battery strap on there now, and you'll see the battery. I've got my rubber pads underneath the battery. It does not move at all. So I also have the CC3D flight controller connected. I need to check my motor connections, but I went 1, 2, 3, 4. I believe that's correct. I just need to double check that before I power it up and see whether or not I have to flash the CC3D flight controller, which I haven't done yet. I haven't checked on it yet. So the other thing, I didn't order any props for this yet. Somehow it slipped my mind, but I'm going to have to get some 6-inch props. These motors have like a little slot on the sides of the thingies here. Oh, why is that so tight? What the hell? Why is that so tight? I don't remember it being tight when I put it on. But yeah, it's got little slots here on either side of where the prop goes. So I'm gonna have to get props that have that little slot in the side. Why that was so hard to get off. I don't remember it being like that when I put it together. Anyways, so I've got my ESC wires all neatly tucked in up the sides here. They come up and run along the edge of the underneath of the battery compartment and then come up to the CC3D flight controller. This is my FPV power. So because the FPV and everything is located in the top half, all I have is this little two-wire connection for that. So that supplies 12 volts to my FPV system. Okay, so the other thing I need to check is see whether the 5 volts supplied by the ESC will actually go from this to my receiver, which is in the top half as well. So I'm going to go ahead and show you the top half now. I got it all finished. It looks really, really nice. So I got my my camera installed there. It's a 1000 TV line camera. Okay. I got my FlySky FS-I IA6B receiver installed here, and I've got all the wires connected that plug into the flight controller. They come out here. So this is one connection here that I need to make, and the other connection is the FPV. So the receiver, I got my 90 degree angle receiver arms. What I ended up doing was just putting the because the antennas have a load partly along, I just ended up putting the wire up through some heat shrink and took the little rubber things off the ends of the tubes. Maybe I can stick them on here. Yeah, look at that. And then I just heat shrinked the antenna wire to the tube itself, so the tube gives it some rigidity. Here at the back now, I have the 5.8 600 milliwatt transmitter for the FPV. So the connections from the